So, Chris, do you want to go again?
I'll do one more.
Alright.
We can't stop this early.
I know.
Too short.
I have more, but you know.
I think so. I knew it would. It kind of kept raining and raining.
Well, it's not raining now.
It was though.
Oh, yeah. That helped really boost enrollment here.
What would?
When they made it a social request.
We're still in the courtroom.
That got a lot of.
Brilliant.
She's in on it.
Brilliant. Yes. We need to start like a poetry group.
I'd love to, but they won't let us do it.
Why won't they let us do poetry? Listen. Okay, I don't know what your life is like in the daytime, but we have a poetry lady who is internationally known, and she comes to the clubhouse every Thursday from 10:30 till noon. And it's free, and she's good, and she gets you inspired and helps you to write. So you guys could come up there for that. And we already have a poetry group, so let's have a poetry group.
Well, you guys should come perform. I can make you guys special guests here.
She's famous.
Let's
make her go.
Well, she's talking about let's bring that poetry from the class.
Yeah. And her too.
We do that. We just need to spread ourselves around. You could really, if you wanted to, come into that poetry group, you would love it.
Yeah.
And you might start writing poetry.
See you next Thursday for lunch.
I've written a poem before.
You have? Yeah. Well, read it.
I don't know where it is.
I've written books and journals, and then I rewrite, and I throw them away.
You don't need to read
it.
Right.
It's just, I can't conquer it.
You can't stop. You're like, I'm really obsessed.
Stubborn as a country view, and I never went to school to learn that trade. I learned it all across this land. I just took my pen in hand. I fought hard, I made my stand, and my dues are paid. I wrote about tortured souls, misplaced goals, and riders on the range. Hunted, driven men who broke some. Fights, the predictable and the strange. I told you once I'm a songwriting fool. I'm a songwriter by birth, above everything else on earth. And I can write you a song of mirth or a song of woe. Whoa. You may think it's all been said, it ain't true, cause I ain't dead. I'm a writer from the top of my head to my little toes. Worried about battle spots, love that's fought, and lives lived out in fear. Misfit children striving to be cool. To love lost, freedom's cost, and girls I once held dear. Say it again, I'm a songwriting fool. Times, and my music and my rhymes peels out like steeple chimes across this land. To the mighty, to the small, I foretell what will befall, and the words and the notes are all at my command. I wrote about kings and clowns, ups and downs, and struggles to be free. Poverty and parties by songwriting fool. I wrote about kings and clowns, ups and downs, and struggles to be free. Poverty and parties by the moon. When I'm gone, write upon my stone for all to see. Here lies the body of a songwriting fool. Thank you. started a new little project recently. I'm writing a musical, like a big musical. I used to write little children's books, and I have a series called The Want Collection. And it's about these little characters called Wunts, W-U-N-T-S, with titles like Once in a Great While, Once on a Dare, Once on a Whim, Once in Around the Block, Once, you know, a bunch of these different things. But it's sort of, you know, the little Wunts, they're from Planet Gorb, and so they have all these little interactions with people, and, but it's kind of an interesting. Just to give you an idea, the first one was called Once in a Great While, and a great while is a great white while. It's like a great white whale, only it's, you know, it's not. It's a great white while, and it begins. There once was a beast called a great white while that lived in the misty deep. Sometimes it floated up near some island, pretended to fall asleep. It liked to pretend it was just a rock jutting up where the waves would break, till an innocent want would happen along, which the while, with a smile, would take. For in all the wide world, there's hardly a thing that a great white while likes more than a tasty want, unless it's a twice, or perhaps even three or four. When wunts get together, wherever they go or wherever they happen to be, it's always a party, for wunts surely know how to party on land or at sea. And anyway, it goes on, and but at the end, it concludes. So the little wunts wait at the mouth of the great wait while it draws near to the shore. In a while, there's such pride when its trap opens wide, it won't notice those ones out the door. So home the ones go, to the sand or the snow, slightly wiser, and sometimes they smile. But they never forget how they once got wet.
No.
And just think of it once in a while.
Oh my God.
So this was the inspiration for my play. I wanted to take like just a summary of all these things. So it sort of looks out. I'll give you an idea. Let's see. There once was a want, was a want, a weary want. There once were two, once a pair of twice. And soon, very soon, there were three under the moon. One, two, and three, once in a trice. How nice then. Four or more made a whole entire galore. A whole galore of ones, to be precise. Once they begin, you get once and once again. Let them in. Only once is my advice. Somewhat like us, strive for the sublime. They always flock to be atop the highest clock, for every rhyme begins with once upon a time. Musical is about the once on planet Gorb and how they're really cool little guys, but they love to gossip. And so if the king wants to send out like a trial balloon to see how people are going to react to some policy change like raising taxes, he tells the once and says, you know, there's a song, I'm only going to tell you once, that's all I got to do. So he tells the once and they tell the world. And they get the story wrong, which turns out to be informative to the people of planet Gorb, and they throw out the bad king, and his not so evil twin takes him and makes him a knight. So it's really kind of an Arthurian themed thing. So Sir Once-a-Lot is sent on a quest to deal with the Great Wile and the Dare and the Pernicious Whim. So in which their books, you know, it's sort of referenced in their little stories. So let me do one more and I'll leave you alone. But he deals with them in this really diplomatic way. He like reasons them into, you know, not being a threat to the, you know, Gorban society. But the king gets mad when he hears this because he thought he was sending Once-a-Lot to kill these monsters, you know. So anyway, he has his knights get fired up to take care of the problem. And the knights are the knights of the brown table. And so it's King Uther and the knights of the brown table. So there's this whole scene where the king has this little scene with his knights. We're the knights of the brown table. We go loyal to and through. We are noble and strong and able, and we're all truly blue. Why must it cause my kingdom so much fuss? Doesn't he know that running this kingdom's none of his business? And where will we be if he don't learn to see like one of us? The knights of the brown table, we are loyal through and through. We are noble and strong and able, and we're all true blue. Such a night as this, what has this upstart Once-a-Lot gone and done? Why must he leave these monsters roaming free? Doesn't he know those beasts will have us on the run? One day he'll be very sorry he didn't pay heed to me. The knights of the brown table, we are loyal through and through. We are noble and strong and able. Thank you.
what?
Eat food. We should go eat all the stuff.
Go for it.
I'm tired.
Go ahead.
I'm gonna go surf the world.
Okay.
Does it ever want to bring in like a section of the script and do a stage read of your?
Oh yeah.
We've done it before.